In this video, I'll show you how to move archive files from one location to another. Some of my archive files are currently sharing a hard drive with my operating system, and because these files are read and written to a lot, moving them to a separate hard drive will increase my machine's performance and stability. I'll also be showing how we could decommission and move archive files to a network location. This can be a useful procedure for disk space management. Here in the Archive tab of System Management Tools, I can see my 10 registered archives. All of them are located on my C drive, except for the current primary archive, who's on the D drive. My operating system is also installed on the C drive, and because these archive files are written to and read from often, when they share a hard drive with the operating system, it can reduce the read and write performance of your PI data archive. If I explore to this C drive, PI Arc directory, we can view these archive files in Windows Explorer. But if I tried to copy and paste any of these files onto my D drive, I won't be able to. Instead, I'll get this error message saying that these files are already open in the PI Archive subsystem. The easiest way to remove this lock is to select the file or files you want in PI System Management Tools, right-click, and then unregister. Before I unregister, however, it's important to know that unregistering this archive will create an archive gap. This is important to know because any data sent to an archive gap will be lost and unrecoverable. So before you create an archive gap, ask yourself if you're doing any backfilling, or expect any data to get written to that time period in question. Since I'm not backfilling at the moment, and all of my interfaces are only writing current data to the primary archive, I should be safe to unregister the historical archive. Here, System Management Tools keeps track of all the files that have recently been registered in a given time period, as noted by this gray text. But if I close System Management Tools and open it again, or simply click Refresh, the user interface will forget what used to be registered here, and this will appear as an archive gap, meaning that no archive is currently registered for this time period. Remember, this archive gap means that any data written to this time period will be lost, so it's important to keep these to a minimum. Let's go back to Explorer and move our archive files from the C drive to our designated archive drive D. Now that the PI data archive no longer has a lock, I can move these as I would any file. So I'll select the two archives I unregistered earlier, along with their annotation file, cut them, and then paste them here in D PI Arc. Back in System Management Tools, right-clicking in my archive window, I can choose to register archive. Then navigate to my archive folder and choose my two moved archives. Once I hit OK, we can see that they've successfully been registered and are now located on the D drive. I left the other archives on the C drive because now I'll show you how we can use wildcards in the command prompt to unregister, move, and register an entire folder of archives all at once. So opening a command prompt as administrator, I'll change my directory to the environment variable PI server/ADM, and here I'll be using the PI R command. I'll start by passing a question mark to view the help dialog. This screen will show us how to use the PI AR tool, and we can see that the proper usage of PI AR tool is PI AR followed by dash, then the command, and then any options we want to add. The commands I'll be using in this video are AR for archive register, and AU for archive unregister. So let's start by using the AU command. I'm going to type in PI rtool and unregister archives, and now I'm going to target my C PyArk folder by typing in C PyArk and then an asterisk to imply that I want to target all the files in that folder. Once it chews through that command, I can see that I've successfully unregistered the rest of the 7 archives on C. Back in System Management Tools, after I refresh, we can see that those archives have indeed been successfully unregistered. There's no archive gap listed this time because archive gaps only appear when there's an archive gap between two registered archives, not at the chronological start of our archive files. But still, since there's no archive files registered for this time period, any data sent to it will be lost forever. Now that the PI.archive doesn't have a lock on these files, I can run a move command from the command prompt. I'll type in move and then C drive PyArch star to imply that I want to target everything in PyArch, and then D drive PyArch. So I'll move everything in C PyArch to D PyArch. This is exactly the same as copying and pasting. And since these archives are unregistered, I could actually choose to do that right now instead. Now, the last step is to run PyAR tool again, and this time using the AR command for archive register. I'll run PyAR tool, AR, and then target everything in my dpyarch folder. This asterisk again means that I want to register all files. I'll get some harmless error messages about trying to register files that are already registered, but the PyAR tool will successfully mass register any other archive in that folder. Back in System Management Tools, after refreshing, we can see that our archive files have all successfully moved to our D drive. The last thing I'll do in this video is decommission my oldest archive file and move it off the machine for safekeeping. It's the exact same procedure as before, starting by unregistering the file, navigating to it, and I'm going to cut it. And paste it in my network directory here. Decommissioning the archive in this way will mean that the PI.archive can no longer query the data in this archive, but we can always register it again if we need that data in the future. If you're looking about more information about external locations and what kind of network storage OSIsoft supports, visit KB482 on our tech support site, or KB3106. Now that we've seen two different ways to unregister, move, and register archives, you can choose the one that makes sense for you. And while it might take a little bit more time to get comfortable using the command prompt on a day-to-day basis at first, you can use those commands in batch files and automatically scheduled tasks to automate parts of your PI administrative duties. In the next video in the series, we'll be detecting, troubleshooting, and running diagnostics on problems with our archive files and the PI.archive archiving process in general.